Thank you. And I still get to keep all the jewelry we find.
Although the enchanted canopy was lovely and captivating, there was a foreboding sense of uneasiness in the air. The further up the heroes climbed, the air around them felt all the more oppressing, especially so for Zoya the thief.
Something's making my skin crawl.
Is it all the pollen from the flowers?
No, it's like this foreboding sense of dread.
Ah, I had that just before my nightmare.
Oh, now that you mention it, me too.
What a dark nook this is.
It reminds me of how all those nightmares jump out of the shadows whenever Prince Celius is around.
Shh, would you two please stop talking about the nightmares already?
Why? Afraid of something.
What?
My throne protects me!
Greetings, heroes. I will complete the potion for you. It should cure the nightmare prince of what ails him.
Thank you so much, miss.
Oh, good. I'm so glad we'll have no reason to fight the poor boy.
Once we make sure he drinks it all.
Amadeus, Pontius, and Zoya pursued Celius again with renewed vigor, now in possession of a chance to help the lost prince. If the prince could be cured of his curse, there'd be no more danger of having to fight him, which had been a distressing prospect to all three of our heroes. They followed Celius's trail by pursuing the numerous nightmares he had summoned in his wake. And so, they found themselves at the snow-topped heights.